Welcome back to Artshop Instructional Drawing Videos. Today we're going to do a little watercolor. And the reference I have is a little magic toad. And he's got kind of a wizard costume. I'm just going to stare at my phone here. And I got this idea from Instagram. And we're just going to go ahead right into it. So first, I got the center. I want to find the center. And I think I'm going to make his eyeball the center today. I'm starting off with a black color pencil. And I'm going to draw my basic shapes, what I need here. And then I'll start coloring them. I got some watercolors and I got a little bit of Spanish, kind of Spanish orange or yellow, a bright yellow, and a green, kind of forest green, and some violet, and it's just watercolor, just some basic colors. So, he's got a little wizard cap on, and I'll make it kind of wavy to give it some kind of natural looking curves, like it's being worn and it's not just a concrete shape. I have another eyeball, another little eye. Got some shade area on the top of the head. We got some magic stars here. I'm gonna go ahead and change a little bit what I see and make this moon a little bit more visible. Excuse me. Hopefully they can edit out that clear in my throat. I'll do half a star here. That looks pretty good. He's got a wide mouth and a little tiny muzzle. I don't know why my voice is a little bit shaky, because I don't have a chair. I'm kind of standing up so that I have better posture. It just helps my back relax while I'm drawing. Now he's got a little cape going over here, a couple little stringy things. Let's make his cape kind of whoosh. Gonna make his cape kind of whoosh and bring his body down a little bit. Start drawing parts of the body. Now I have some kind of odd looking elbows. Not really seeing too much feet, so I'm just kind of making up what I think is gonna be there. So now I'm starting to put some darker line work in. And just kind of double line everything. Or I mean, just kind of trace over the lines. The kind of wide, rough lines that I got. And just kind of smooth them out. Break in some of these outlines. To give it some more natural kind of light. I'm gonna go ahead and shade this in with my black. Because it seems to be pretty effective. More shade here, make a little bit of contours, excuse me, I'm just throwing a little bit of shade here and there. Real soft circle motions. I'm gonna go dark right here. All in this kind of make like a dark half circle here. And just kind of whip it out to make a softer shade. You have a nice blend there. Thin line work here. Now, see where my outlines are more in the body, they're kind of thicker, and right about here. They kind of get thin up here. And that's to give the illustration a kind of realistic feel. And he's got some spots. Try to do as much as this with the pencil that I can. So now under the fingers I have a little bit thicker outlines, gives it more natural feel. Draw one more little toe sticking out here. The froggies kind of have little wrinkly bodies. Spotty spots using real light circle motions, a little bit of stipple technique, and we'll do a kind of a contour shade that'll give his body a little bit of physique where there's kind of muscle areas, just a couple little wrinkles here. More wrinkles. Frogs are kind of wrinkly. Do a little bit more shade in his cheeky area. Give him some kind of special effects. Got give him some special effects and kind of make him look pretty a little bit. He's a good looking guy. Good looking little frog guy. She's got a nice little cape, knows magic. It's always nice to kind of look at your characters and make up stories about them. Imagine what they would be doing. What they like to eat. If they can talk. All kinds of stuff. I'm doing a nice dark shadow in his underbelly. A little bit of contour shading. A little bit of broken outlines. And now we'll do a little bit of shade over here just to kind of break up the negative space around him, where we have positive subject matter in the middle, and then we have all this kind of space around here. Just go ahead and throw some nice shade. Now I'm going to go into my colors. We got a nice wide area, so I'm going to go with this flat brush here. It's not too big. I'm going to go with some violet. And just start going around in his cape where there's nice solid areas. Now you can add some dark, kind of stay in the middle. You can work those lines with the flat edge of your brush. Now I got some dark up here, just take straight water. Kind of push it out. And the more spots you have from where the water kind of dries, the more better it's gonna look. So if I throw some spots in and kind of let them dry, it's gonna leave a nice watermark where I can do some layering. Well, we won't worry about that. Just want to put some nice purple in. Whoops, almost went outside, lines a little bit. Throw some nice purple here. So now I have some nice smooth shade and some nice dark areas. She gives it a kind of realistic vibe. Throw in some contour shading. I can start tilting the brush a little bit, maybe make some kind of secondary wrinkles. So, go ahead and clean that brush off. I'm gonna go with one of these detail brushes. Start putting in some nice bright yellow. I do have a secondary yellow that I think I want to blend in a little bit. And it doesn't matter if you go outside the lines a little bit. I'm not worried about it. It's already starting to look pretty good. Get some stars over here. Go with the straight paint. And I'll probably just add some dots just to mix it up. Go ahead into my green. I'm gonna go and mix some yellow. Try to mix some yellow and a little bit of yellow in my green to make a secondary kind of green color around the lip area. We'll do some in the hands. Do some spotting. Go ahead and blend some yellow in. You can go ahead and take yellow and then spot green in if you want. Kind of play around with it. I want a nice secondary green right here where I have this kind of primary flat green, and then I'm gonna blend it in a little bit. See where it's kind of drying up, it's kind of sticky, and the more water I put in it, the lighter I can get a nice blend. The yellowy kind of green. So now I'll take this bright yellow green, finish up with the ends of the toes, and that's starting to look finished here. This kind of murky green. I'm gonna throw some more in the face just because it gives them personality. try to fill in the background. And all I did was take the purple and the green and mix them together. To make this really dark color. It looks black. And then I just take water and kind of blend it out. Make a nice fade. Go real hard next to the outline. And then just push it out with some water. That looks good so far. I'm gonna keep that going a little bit. But we can go ahead and call this one done. From here you can go ahead and, you know, just kind of water down your paper and really kind of experiment. Take this round brush, straight water in that blank area, and just keep washing it off. Make a nice water blend. Not too dark, not too light. Try to leave a nice white spot up against his little outline here. And there we go. Sign your name. Oh, that's pretty cool. Thanks everybody, that was really fun.